Hi guys, good morning. Okay, so I just wanted to give you guys a little backstory on what I shared earlier. The struggle that I was talking about, and my eyes was focused not where it should have been. Years ago, Jeff had a hard battle with a pacemaker, and it was a long haul, but thank God he renewed him. He gave him a miracle, and the pacemaker got taken out. No pills, anything like that. And during that time, we were involved in church. Our marriage was completely based on God. We were husband and wife together, serving the Lord. And 2017, he got the pacemaker taken out. Fast forward from 13 to 17. And from then on, the enemy came against Jeff with family issues with his dad, and there was all kind of trouble, and it just brought Jeff down. Where the path he was on, I guess the enemy couldn't stand that, so we had to use something to sneak in and attack and rob him of that joy of even being completely renewed, a miracle, literally a walking miracle. Anyway, so from then on, he started drinking again. Not, you know, out of the ordinary, but he didn't drink since, like, for maybe 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, like about 4 years. And then that led to getting high. So completely something I was shocked of. I thought our life was different. I thought our journey was going together on this way, and he kind of just made a detour, and I felt alone. I felt, why is this happening, Lord? Like, wow. And I would tell him that, like, you're not even on the same page with me anymore. You're not even on the same journey. And he'd be like, yeah, it is. And then all through these years, I guess I lost myself and lost focus of hanging on to Jesus through it, and I kept focusing on the outcome. Why, Lord? Why with the weed, the negative words, just that ugly feeling inside me where I kept praying for him over all these years, and not angry at God, but just frustrated and angry about the situation and how the enemy just came in and stole all that. And how do I get back there? How do I get back to that place I felt before, that that anointing in God's presence? I just felt I can't get back there. I don't feel the same. All the while I'm praying, like, Lord, what is it? Are you hearing me? Hello? Do you have anything for me? What do you want from me? Why is things got to be like this? Why can't I feel you? Why can't I get back to that place we was before? Even if he don't, right now, me. And I struggled really hard with him with the weed, and I still do, but not the last month. I finally not accepted it, but literally gave it to God, and it's not up to me. It's between Jeff and God, and he has to do that. So all I can do is just pray for God to open his eyes and lighten him and see the truth. But all through these years of complaining and focusing, it's him, Lord, change him. Once he's changed, you know, our life will be back to normal. Once he gets healed and delivered, like, we'll be back to normal. Things will be the way it was. And all along through all these years, I I was focused on the outcome of when Jeff is fixed, when he is awake and sees the truth, then everything will be good. I completely missed the process that God doesn't fix something. So he don't just put a band-aid on us and say, okay, you're good now. Like, okay, you're fine. But he's making things new. And I failed to trust him in the process along the way. And I was too much looking over there at, okay, once Jeff is fixed, we'll be fine. Everything will be normal. And I miss that he doesn't do that. He makes new. He creates new. So it's better than it was before. So I couldn't get back to that place because he had something better. So through all these years, he was working on me, refining me, putting me through the fire, testing me to be stronger, making new, creating in me a new heart, which I've been praying for. And I'd pray, you know, and you just pray and you're like, not praying in sola, but you're just like, yeah, Lord, I need this. And you say this, I know that, but we have the wrong attitude about it. It's just our self gets in the way. And the other night, Friday I had a really bad day, and then Saturday night, everything that I shared, he just poured into me who I am, what I am in him. And all that time, I finally realized Saturday, it was me. I needed a true heart of repentance. I needed to get off that negative overflow off my heart that built up from the circumstances the enemy used with my husband that made me blind to the truth. And I've been praying and praying and praying for God to open Jeff's eyes, Lord, John 9, you know, make the blind see. And all along, I was the one that needed that. I thought I seen. I thought I knew. It's just amazing. I'm totally in awe of God, but that has been my struggle over these years. Even who am I? What am I supposed to do for you? What do you want from me? You never tell me, Lord. You don't speak to me. You don't show me. Speak to me. Why don't you speak to me? Am I not good enough? I can't hear you. What do you want from me? All these years until I realized it was me that needed a true heart of repentance. And then he just flowed through it. So I'm just so thankful for that. I just wanted to give you guys a little story. I said over the few years I've been struggling with it and my eyes was focused on the wrong thing. But I'm so thankful, and I'm still in awe and learning what all this means that he told me that I am a lampstand. I am an iron pillar. I am a staff. I am a bridgeway. I am a tool. And he spoke so clear and gave me all these scriptures, and just all the picture came together in his word. And I'm just so thankful that God is always faithful. He's always working behind, even when we don't feel it, when we don't see it. He is making all things new. He has taken the broken. All along, I was broken inside. But I didn't really know. Or if I knew, I tried to just, no, you're not, you're fine. It's not you. It's him. It's him. It's him. It's him. It's him. Everything was him because he was doing this one thing. But all the blame wasn't on him. But the enemy used that to blind me from me, that I'm the one that needs the work in. I can't change Jeff. I can just pray. And the rest is up between Jeff and God. And I'm just so thankful. I just wanted to share that with you guys, that God is truly amazing in making something completely new from the dust. The dust mixed with water. Like God is the potter, we are the clay. Dust mixed with water becomes clay. And it becomes new, whatever the potter has in mind, whatever he has planned. That is what he fashions up. And through all of this time, the struggles, that is what he's been doing in me. And it finally finally, God showed me and revealed to me as part of my journey. So it is a testimony, an answered prayer in my life that I've been struggling with about my own self. And I'm so thankful that God is showing me and revealing to me. And I don't know what that looks like. I don't know what does that mean. But I'm just going to trust in Him and His timing. And His plan will start to unfold. But I'm excited for the journey of being renewed and a true heart of repentance. And just to share with everyone Jesus and to be bold and courageous for God. To stand up, to be ready, to share it with boldness and not sit back and be quiet about it, but to share it, to help everyone else in their journey and just to bring the glory to God for what He's doing in myself over these years. So just keep me up in prayer. I still struggle with a lot of things. The enemy knows how to get at me, but I'm like, okay, you're done now, not anymore. My God is bigger than the struggle. So I just wanted to share a little bit of my heart with you guys, and so God bless you guys.